Jerry 501 here. I'm in the Agriculture Defense Coalition website. This website was put up by Rosalind Peterson. I am in the U.S. Navy tab, and this is in regards to the military training exercises that have been ongoing for, I don't know, since what, 2003 or I don't know, something absolutely ludicrous. Anyway, this letter here is dated 2009. In many regions, the Navy plans to increase the number of its exercises or expand the areas in which they may occur, and virtually every coastal state will be affected. Some exercises may occur in the nation's most biological sensitive marine habitats, including National Marine Sanctuaries and breeding habitat for, one example, the endangered North Atlantic right whale. In all, worldwide, the Navy anticipates more than 2.3 million takes, or what is significant disruptions in marine mammal foraging, breeding, essential behaviors, just basically their existence. And that's over a course of 1 year, 2.3 million takes per year. And in the course of the 5-year permit, it would be 11.7 million takes. So actually, a take is said to be 'take' defined under the Marine Mammal Protection Act as harass, hunt, capture, kill, collect, attempt to harass, hunt, capture, kill, or collect, defined under the Endangered Species Act as to harass, harm, pursue, hunt, shoot, wound, kill, trap, capture, collect, or attempt to engage in any such conduct. So this is the expansion map that I'm sure they just ran it through. There was supposedly an awful lot of people suing the government and everything else, but you know what? They don't care, and they're going to do whatever they want. So, as it is now, the entire eastern seaboard, the Gulf of Mexico, and there are even some small areas that extend into, I think it's Louisiana, I'm not sure, don't quote me on that, please. The Hawaiian Islands, Southern California, San Diego, and out that way. Washington, Oregon, Northern California, Alaska, Gulf of Alaska, Mariana Islands. So, let's see. The mass dolphin deaths in Peru were caused by acoustic trauma. I think we all knew that. However, this was actually confirmed by Dr. Yapin Leaños of Orca in Peru. And that killed an estimated 1,000 dolphins along the coast of northern Peru. This is another reason to begin to limit sonar, laser, radar, and electromagnetic weapons testing all over the world, but specifically in the Atlantic, Pacific, and the Gulf of Mexico. So, I'm going to, I'd like to give credit to Rosalind Peterson. You can write to her, you can email her, and thank her for this website. If you spend any time in here, you're just going to be amazed at, I don't know, thousands and thousands of pages of information that she went through and put in this site. there's just so many links that it's just not even funny. But I'm going to bring you down to this one. This was in January 26th in San Francisco.
Well, we saw a destroyer on the horizon coming toward Harrow Strait. And actually, before we even saw it, we heard it.
So let me just say that this is the voice of Ken Balcom. He's the executive director of the Center for Whale Research. You can contact Steve Mashuda at Earth Justice if you would like to get involved here. And let's see, this next one is the same video, except I want you to hear the ending of this. And you look how far away this is. So normally, what they're supposed to have is a 17th century ridiculous spotter up here. And he's supposed to keep his eye out. And if he sees anything within a little ways away, then they're supposed to mitigate and stop what they're doing until the animals pass. Well, they don't. They don't do that. That's why the dolphins all died off of Peru, because they didn't do that, and they didn't do it in 2003 when 20 killer whales and dozens of porpoises were forced to flee the waters near the San Juan Islands after a Navy ship passed with its active sonar blasting. And Mr. Ken Balcom just happened to be out there, and so this is you can see how much closer they are. They see research vessels around.
Yeah, it goes up and then goes down.
These guys are, they don't know where
to go.
Well,
that's what they were telling me in here, but
okay, this is them. This is these whales crying. A lot of these animals go deaf.
Go ahead.
They've got nowhere to go. They can't get away. It'd be nice if Obama's children could watch this and say, thank you, Daddy.
Yeah,
thank you, Daddy.
Well, I'm getting.
So, okay. So I am going to go back in and make another video, but so this is what they're asking for this year in their level A and B harassment authorization. They actually have to ask for harassment authorization requests. And there's no changes. Same thing. We know we're gonna maim, kill. For some reason, beaked dolphins and whales seem to be, beaked whales seem to be extremely sensitive. So here we go. Annual requests take for 1 year, 2012 to 2013. This means disrupt them in any way, shape, or form. And it doesn't matter if they've got babies. It doesn't matter if they're in a birthing area. It doesn't matter where they are. Okay, so gray whales, in 1 year, their plan to disrupt 6,000 gray whales, 500 bluefin, 13 humpback, beaked whales. These are the ones that are seem to be a little bit more sensitive. Bottlenose dolphins, 1,600. Longbeak common dolphin, 5,092. 4,000 rizzos, 43,000. Shortbeak common dolphin. Okay, so some of these numbers, what really bothers me is because I actually studied the spinner dolphins in the Big Island of Hawaii in Kealakekua Bay. And that was the tail end of what Kenneth Norris did over on the Big Island for years and years and years. And he finally ended up trying to study them. It was pretty interesting. Anyway, we've got 61,000 sea lions. Now, I live next to a city called Seal Beach, and there are no more seals in Seal Beach. It was named Seal Beach because there were so many seals there, and there are none. None. Maybe there's a couple up on the breakwaters, but they're not on the beaches like they used to be. So those are some pretty staggering numbers. Pretty staggering numbers, and that was just my whole point, is that this is just business as usual. Let me see. There is up here. There is the toll-free number for our elected officials in Washington, D.C. Please, please make a phone call, write a letter, do an email. I don't care what it is, but, you know, it's so frustrating because I know sometimes we feel like we can't do anything and our voice doesn't matter. But that's what's going to make us go crazy, because you don't know. Look at this woman, Rosalind Peterson. Look at this amazing website she put together just of information. So 866-220-0044. And as always, God bless, and let's be good stewards and make some phone calls and protest all this military bonanza, buffoonery, dumping poisons, electromagnetic energy, bombs, sonar. I mean, it's just, the list goes on and on and on. So, it's time to make a stand.